I'm Shaniya Peart. I am from Bayshore, New York, and I am a senior mathematics major at Villanova University.
Hi, my name is Alayt Issak. I am currently a visiting scholar at the University of Illinois in Urbana-Champaign within the Coordinator Science Laboratory. And the research that I do is within the intersection of visual arts, creativity, and AI, artificial intelligence. I recently graduated in mathematics and studio art from the College of Worcester in Worcester, Ohio.
So I originally came to Villanova as a chemistry major, and I spent about three semesters as a chemistry major before I realized that the most attracting part about chemistry for me was the mathematics. And as I was getting up into classes that didn't involve math, I started to enjoy them less. And so I decided to switch my major in the second semester of my sophomore year to mathematics. Eventually, during my junior year, I took some courses that were focused more on pure mathematics. Like I took some, I mean, all of my courses have been more pure mathematics, but I took some more, like I took number theory and abstract algebra and advanced calculus. And I really enjoyed the proofs and learning the pure mathematical concepts. And that's when I decided that I really like to pursue a graduate degree in pure mathematics. And my experience with the David Harold Blackwell Summer Research Institute really helped to just solidify that decision, because I got to get a hands-on experience in what it's like to be a pure mathematics research mathematician.
The way I learned about the Blackwell Institute was actually in my pursuit of finding my post-grad trajectory. Upon the completion of my junior year, I knew upon graduation that I did not seek to get into an industry role nor a PhD, because I needed time for critical thinking about what I wanted to do, what I wanted to study. And so I wanted to provide myself with a post-bac that would allow me to conduct research within my interests and at the same time think about what I want to do.
My program mentor was Dr. Wilfrid Gangbo from UCLA, and my project was finite dimensional non-commutative optimal mass transport. The topic is what Professor Gangbo's primary research is in optimal mass transport theory, and so that's how I came upon it. I never heard of it before. The whole premise of the problem is trying to transport a mass or multiple mass units in the most efficient way.
My mentor at the Institute was Professor Todd Coleman. It was I enjoyed my experience very much. I think it was absolutely priceless to begin with, the project that we worked on. So essentially, I've always known that I wanted to expand my knowledge of mathematics within an applied sense. And as an artist as well, the way I sought to combine those two together currently is through AI art, for instance. But I knew I wanted to pivot because Professor Todd Coleman is in bioengineering. I thought, well, I can pivot to within biology. It's these leaps of faith that you take and that get you to the places where you never know you can end up. And it was absolutely beautiful. And the project we worked on was, in a sense, we had data on a patient, a diabetic patient, blood glucose levels, as well as their stomach activity. And there was there was a relationship that was noticed in a sense where your blood glucose and your stomach activity are inversely related. And so there was a relationship that we noticed, and we wanted to model that. And we created an autoregressive model. And there was a relationship that we were able to find. However, it wasn't significant, which is understandable because our data needed a larger context about what food the patient was intaking at what time. And however, it was good because we were able to create a stepping stone towards this thinking, and also understand the data not only from, or what was observed in the data, not only from a data point of view, but also from a theoretical point of view, because the model we're creating goes down to the fundamentals of linear algebra, which is the fundamentals of mathematics and applied mathematics.
The program really just introduced me to what it was like to do mathematics research in pure mathematics. I originally have only experience with mathematics in the sense of chemistry and computational chemistry. And so it was nice to experience research from a purely mathematics standpoint, which is something I was interested in studying in grad school. And it was also helpful because it was more of like getting to learn from Professor Gangbo and my TA, Mohit Bansal, who's a PhD student at UCLA. They were very helpful in sort of giving me like a quick, brief introduction to real analysis or complex analysis, which was helpful and will be helpful next semester when I take the course.
So my research interests since then have gradually changed, mainly because now I'm more open to pivoting, pivoting in terms of not restricting myself within mathematics and arts, but also pivoting to other other fields. I'm more open to fields such as the environmental sciences, because I do find myself as a sustainable and holistic person. So it's been very eye-opening towards the possibilities of what I can even go to and pursue within my studies, within my PhD, and ask myself the different collaborations that I can also undertake while I'm conducting a PhD in the near future.
I found that this program was very unique. I'm sure there's probably some more like this, but at least in my search, this program seemed very unique because it was geared towards, specifically towards African American mathematicians or Black mathematicians. And, you know, there are other minority mathematicians in the program, but I think that that was something that made this program stand out to me as opposed to other REUs, which I did apply to, because it was focused on increasing Black mathematicians and the amount of Black PhD mathematicians in the world, which is something that I'm really passionate about. And considering I go to a school where there's not many Black mathematicians as professors or as students, and it was nice to get a chance to learn from professors who shared similar experiences with me and looked like me.
Coming out of it, there was a change in trajectory, which has occurred and which I am grateful for, because it has opened my mind towards this year that I'm taking to critically think about my trajectory. And so it has absolutely impacted me, but more so than the project, also interacting with the professors and interacting with them on a human basis, because we would meet for lunch virtually. And during those moments, we would ask questions and I got to know them as human beings and ask the questions that I wanted to, or even know how to interact with professors as other humans going through, you know, their life experiences. And there wasn't a level of hierarchy that limited whether a question was applicable or not. And it was just a holistic understanding that I was able to gain about how, what it would mean to pursue a PhD in mathematics. Well, overall, hearing their experiences, I think, if anything, I saw a lot of ambition. And I believe that if anything, one takeaway of like, if I take away a word, it would be ambition, because they are very ambitious and it just gives you a drive, I would say. And so I would say it was a absolutely amazing experience and I wouldn't change it for anything. And I am sure and certain that it's going to be a program that will impact me.
I would say my love for math really began at Villanova with the math professors that I've had here. As a chemistry major, I had to take calculus 1 and 2. And my professor here at Villanova, I had Dr. Vikram Kamat for calculus 1, and he was very encouraging and helpful and just allowed me to build up my confidence in my mathematical abilities, which continued through my classes. And then I saw that sort of pour into my chemistry classes with the math, is that I was getting more confident with math and it was becoming something that I could really see myself doing and enjoy doing. And so that's how I sort of became a math lover. So I think that cultivating students, especially minority students or Black students who want or interested or want to be interested in math, really starts in the younger years in elementary and in those level courses. And I think it really depends on the teachers realizing that a lot of students of color, a lot of Black students don't come from family backgrounds where they are getting homework help. And so when they're learning math in class, that is the first time they're seeing it. And it's the only experience that they are going to have with it for a lot of students, not true for all, but true for many, that, you know, their parents, at least for me, I'm a first generation American and a first generation college student. So I didn't have parents who went to college And they didn't go to school in America, so it was very hard to get homework help. And I was basically doing everything on my own when I wasn't in class. And so I think it's important to know that not every student is receiving the same help at home. And so it can be discouraging when other students who have parents who can help them understand math or take them to math tutoring. Like, I could never go to tutoring because my mother had to work all of the time. And so I could only, my only help was myself. And so that's true for a lot of Black students, is that even as they go into college, that, you know, some of them, they have to work to support themselves because they come from single parent households or because they just come from lower income households. And so they have to work to support themselves and they can't really focus as heavily as they would, as their white counterparts or more affluent counterparts on math or on their homework or on anything. And so it's very discouraging, especially because math is so, you have to get it. Like, you just have to, like, there's the right answer. And it's not, as, I mean, as you go into the higher level courses, of course, there's more ways to do proofs and things, but when you're really in like calculus, there's really just one answer, and a lot of students don't have enough time to devote to that, which makes them shy away from math or think that math is scary because they don't have as much time to devote to something that doesn't come naturally for a lot of people. Like, I don't know, for me, math didn't come naturally. I had to work at it. And so I would say just having more resources in general that are targeted at helping these students to get a more background in math outside of the classroom or even in the classroom, just having, like for me, having a teacher that encouraged me and I guess, you know, not paid me special attention, but complimented me when I did well in math helped me to want to continue to do it.
As for my career goals, I do know much more in the future. There is a sense in me that I do want to become a farmer, and a farmer because I'm from Ethiopia, and growing up, what my mother always said, well, this is in Amharic, and it says, well, Saimari Asamanishin Gabariatashi, which means don't forget the farmer who taught you that teaching themselves because of the way the economy is set up. And I think coming to college, I came to the middle of Ohio in the Midwest, and I saw how farming is actually was a respected field in many senses. And I think I've always seen it that way, but going back to Ethiopia and becoming a farmer was something that I've always wanted to. And here I was able to see a different perspective. And in order to become a farmer, I think because it's very much ingrained within nature, I want to develop these quantitative skills or qualitative skills to eventually allow me to have these, the knowledge to have a farm, not only in a sense of production, but also to bring myself closer to nature and to integrate my knowledge for the greater good of a larger community.
After graduate school, I'm hoping to do research. I haven't decided if I want to stay in academia and be a professor and also do research, or if I want to branch out, but the goal is to do research.